Good day to you. Today we're looking at a chapter called recruitment. Recruitment is a very important concept in the HRM area. So what is recruitment? How important is recruitment to the survival of an organization, the image that it conveys to the market? So let us take a deeper look at the recruitment process. The labor market can be defined as a place where labor is bought and sold, and the typical market concepts of demand, supply and price operates. Now, as an organization, you need to track the changes in the labor market, the demographic trends, the birth rate, the death rate, the number of students coming out of colleges, the skill levels that is available for you to recruit from the market, the diversity, the male-female ratios, you know, considering all the legislations that is being brought out for inclusivity. You need to consider what is the ratio available in the market, skills and qualifications available, what is your organization's requirement, does the local market offer you all the skills and qualifications required, or should you go for somewhere, the external market, from the place where you're operating. That is something which you need to consider. Internal source of labor, within your organization, what is the level of skills and competencies with which you can surge forward. Promotion and succession. How do you make way for the employees to grow within an organization? And succession planning, that is important. Internal versus external recruitment. Whether you're going to adopt a strategy for an internal recruitment or an external recruitment from the market. Let us define recruitment. Recruitment is a process whereby an organization communicates opportunities and information to the labor market in order to attract the quantity and quality of potential employees it requires to fulfill its resource plan. So let's say, for example, a company ABC, there is a vacancy, it wants to approach the market. So it communicates the vacancy through a medium and it attracts applications from the most suitable candidates, and then goes through a process of selection. So recruitment is that process wherein the company communicates opportunities and information to the labor market, the target audience, in order to attract the quantity and quality of potential employees. Let us take a look at a video at a slightly different organization which we all love to join, an army. So how do they attract people? Let's take a look at this.
In every job, you have to be sharp on time. In every job, you can get an office. In every job, you have urgent meetings. In every job, you can get a company car. In every job, you depend on your colleagues. In every job, you can get a promotion. In every job, you can go on business trips. In every job, you can work overtime. In every job, you have domestic situations. But only in one job, you serve the country. Slovenian Army, serving the country.
That's an inspiring video. Now, as you would have seen from the ad, it is communicating the actual job requirements and the skills which is expected from the candidates. Now, they are giving you an exact picture. There is no misleading information involved. The actual workplace is shown to you. What you are going to do as part of a member of the army is shown to you. So you get a realistic picture. There is no miscommunication whatsoever. That is the kind of communication employers are expected to communicate to the labor market and to potential applicants. Let's move on. Let us take a deeper look at recruitment. Now, it is a systematic approach. There is no haphazard approach to this. That's a systematic approach. No, it involves human resource planning, job analysis, identification of vacancies, evaluation of the sources of skills, preparation and publication of recruitment information, and processing applications. Now, human resource planning is a fundamental step wherein you would know what is required in the organization in terms of the jobs, the job content. So you will get the number of vacancies. You do a job analysis, you know, the kind of jobs required in the organization to meet the business objectives. You get it through job analysis. Identification of vacancies, the vacancies which might hamper your business continuity, the vacancies which can be filled in over a period of time, a short run, long run, all sort of vacancies can be identified. Evaluation of the source of skills. What is your current skill level inside the organization? What is the requirement from the market? You get to know what is what as it is basis. Now, preparation and publication of recruitment information. As a video we saw earlier, you have to prepare and publish the recruitment information in order to attract the applicants at the right time. Processing applications. As in when you receive the applications, you should have a streamlined process in order to segregate and process the applications to put them into proper slots for you to process and call the applicants for the interview. Recruitment policy and best practice. Now let's look at some of the practices. Internal advertisement of vacancies. This is a practice which is found in almost all modern organizations, because first chance goes to insiders, because they know the company better, they are in your culture, and they'll give you a better option. Internal advertisement of vacancies. You have intranet portals wherein you post the job vacancy, suitable candidates will apply and they'll go through the interview process. Next comes efficient and courteous processing of applications. Now, every applicant deserves respect. As in when you receive an application, you need to respond. Now, it's better if you have a personalized response, or at the least you have an automated response, so that you know you care for the applicant. Fair and accurate provision of information to potential recruits. There should be a realistic projection of the job requirements, the skills required, so that there is no false picture given to the applicant. It always helps to form a psychological contract when it comes to the actual job performance of the new recruit. Discrimination. Selection of candidates on the basis of qualification without discrimination. Now, the employment legislations are very particular about discrimination. This is an emerging trend wherein all kinds of discriminations are struck down by employment tribunals and courts. So make sure you don't follow discriminating practices in the recruitment process. Recruitment of local labor. When it comes to recruitment of local labor, there is a huge say from the legislations, and also as part of your competitive strategy, you are bound to go for local labor to create more employment opportunities to survive in the local market. Moving on. Now, what influences your recruitment policy? The organization's image, human resource plan, fairness, courtesy and professionalism, legislation and regulations. Now, the organization's image is the most important factor when it comes to your recruitment policy. What is the image that the market has about your company? Are you a good paymaster? Are you totalitarian in nature? What is the kind of respect your employees deserve in the market? So the image plays a vital role in the applicant's mind. Human resource plan. Now, your recruitment strategies always are derived from the human resource plan. So an effective human resource plan is of vital importance to your recruitment success. Fairness, courtesy and professionalism. These are indicators of the quality of organization that you are going to work for. Now, how is the entire process being dealt with in the company? Is it fair? Is there courtesy involved? And is it professional? So legislation and regulations, as I mentioned earlier, legislations have a big impact on the way recruitments are carried out. And regulations are being tweaked every day so that there is no scope for any kind of discrimination. Now, there are two types of discrimination, let us say direct discrimination and indirect discrimination. Direct discrimination is a scenario wherein the employer deliberately and in a very open manner is discriminating against a particular group of people from entering his organization or the employment pool. The indirect discrimination is in a way On the surface level, everything seems to be okay. There is no potential dispute involved, but there is a very subtle form of discrimination. Let us say, for example, an employer gives an ad saying that candidates with 6 foot height can apply for this job. Now the possibilities are more number of men will apply than women. So this is a very subtle form of discrimination, but the employer can defend himself saying it is just a requirement of the job. So this falls in the category of indirect discrimination.